The ocean is a really big and vast place. In order to reach a lot of the animals and life that lives there, it requires state-of-the-art technology.
It's really hard to approach animals in the Midwater and get really good images of it and then sample them.
In 2019, we came out and did a demonstration cruise where we brought versions of our technology to sea. So this cruise is the first science mission where we're applying those technologies to really try and tackle these questions about how can you more efficiently discover life in the ocean. It can take up to 10 years to describe an animal once it's been initially discovered. What we're trying to do is combine both imaging and collections or DNA sampling to basically speed up that entire process.
We have three different systems on here, two really advanced imaging systems and then this encapsulation sampling system that goes into it. Usually those would go one at a time because they're quite advanced and complex in its own and their own rights. But we've combined them now onto the vehicle at once so that we can go from one, do it for 5 minutes, go to the next, do it 5 minutes, and do it to the next. And when you stand back and look at the amount of information that we're gathering in that short time period, it's quite staggering.
DPIV is an instrument we've been developing since 2015. With a laser and an imager or a camera, we can actually capture the movement of particles or even gelatinous structures in a really thin plane or sheet of light. Iris in a single frame will capture the three-dimensional surface of a moving object. And we can capture that information at 60 frames per second. Not only are we creating three-dimensional structures of animals, but we're also looking at their movements, animal movements, their mechanics, and how they're able to move in this fluid, deep environment.
After we do all that wonderful imaging and gather a lot of data about the animal, we're able to encapsulate it in this device we call the rotary actuated dodecahedron. RAT2 is really this idea I think many midwater biologists have had, where wouldn't it be great if I could just reach out and grab it? And we actually can do that. It surrounds the animal, and then inside of it, we can cleave off pieces of its tissue and preserve it in situ in the environment. With that type of sample, we're able to gather a lot of genetic data about the animal as well.
The largest habitable space within the ocean is the ocean's midwaters, but it's one of the least explored places.
We know very, very little about it.
Within that region, there's a lot of life. If we haven't been observing that region, you know, what are we missing?
If we can do a really good job of describing what's there, we can understand the changes that we're making on that environment moving forward.
Really, what I'm hoping is we can create engagement, help bring people into the ocean and realize that it is also this amazing place filled with life we don't know pretty much anything about.